George Pell has fled Melbourne for New South Wales, wasting no time making the most of his newfound freedom. The 78-year-old leaves behind a city divided, protesters vandalising St Patrick's Cathedral after the Cardinal's acquittal. Reid Butler has the story.
Once one of the world's most senior Catholics.
I'm sorry I'm not dressed a bit better, but I didn't expect this.
George Pell carved a very different figure at this service station in Glen Rowan.
What was your reaction yesterday?
I was very pleased.
Appearing frail and wearing a cardigan, the 78-year-old and a friend purchase a newspaper and a phone charger. And as the Cardinal leaves, he tells the media to step back.
Excuse me, social distance.
Less than 24 hours after being released from Barwon Prison, Pell made the most of his newfound freedom and headed to Sydney this morning, leaving in his wake a city still reeling from the judgment which saw the Cardinal acquitted of child sex convictions.
For a lot of survivors, they find the acquittal to be quite triggering, and for many it's quite gut-wrenching and devastating.
One woman tied this children's tricycle to the front gate of the Kew Monastery where Pell spent last night. It was removed this morning. Harder to erase, this anti-Pell graffiti splashed across St Patrick's Cathedral's doors. Symbols of the Antichrist and the words "No Justice" staining the doors and gates in dripping red and white paint.
There remain such strong emotions around all of this matter, so I'm not surprised it happened.
But I hope people would understand that this is ultimately just one case. Other cases will proceed in the future. There's no question that cases will be prosecuted, and there's no doubt there'll be convictions based on allegations of historical sexual abuse.
Today, the lawyer for Witness J, Pell's key accuser, spoke for the first time since the convictions were quashed.
We both accept that in this case, the court reached the view that the prosecution hadn't discharged the evidentiary burden of beyond all reasonable doubt.
This is a case which failed at the final hurdle because of deficiencies in the evidence and a technical analysis of that evidence.
A statement too from the Vatican. Entrusting his case to the court's justice, Cardinal Pell has always maintained his innocence and has waited for the truth to be ascertained. The trip from Melbourne to Sydney takes 9 hours, a long journey for anyone, particularly someone like George Pell, who in recent years has had both of his knees operated on. It's understood that the Cardinal has family in New South Wales and may be hoping to retire in the state. Freedom at last, but Pell could face more legal battles. With several civil suits in the works, there's still a long road ahead. Reid Butler, Nine News.